Hey guys, I am back with another very exciting tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can create an awesome looking animated glass morphism effect that is super easy to create inside of After Effects without using any third-party plugins. This is Vikas from Skyline Motions, and without any further ado, let's get started. Alright, so here we are in Adobe After Effects, and let's start by creating a new composition. So click on this new composition button, or you can just go over here and take a new composition, and this is going to be our main composition, so you can call it main. Set the size of this composition 1920 in width, 1080 in height, and we have to select a frame rate. So in this case, I am using this 30 frame per second. You can select 60 frame per second for smooth animation or 24 frame per second for cinematic. And we have to set the duration of this composition maybe 10 seconds long, which is good enough for one slide. And you can select any background color. Hit OK. And now we have to create a background, so it's very simple. Just go to layer, go to new, and take a new solid layer. And this is going to be our background, so I'm going to call it busy. And we have to select a dark blue color for this background. So click on this color box and let's select this type of dark blue color. You can select black color as well. Hit OK. And now we have the dark blue color. After that, let's create colorful circular shape. So it's very simple. Just click on this blank area. Let's select ellipse tool from here, just like this. Click on this fill, set it to solid color. Click on this stroke and set it to none. And hold left mouse button, hold control, shift, alt on the keyboard. And let's create circular shape just like this. And after that, select the move tool. Open this ellipse one, open this ellipse path one, and here we have the size. So let's set the size maybe 800. Now it's perfect. Let's close the shape layer, select the shape layer, and we have to set the anchor point in the center of the circle. So hold control on the keyboard and just double click on this pan behind tool and set the anchor point in the center of the circle. Select the move tool. Let's place the circle right over here, just like this. Alright, and now let's apply some effect on it. So it's very simple. Just go to effect and preset. If you don't have this effect and preset, then go to window and check this option effect and preset. And let's search for displace. So this is the turbulent displace effect. Let's apply this turbulent displace on this shape layer, just like this. And we have to do some basic setting. So just go to amount and let's set the amount 35. Let's increase the size and set the value 200. And now we have to animate the offset. So just go to very first frame of this animation. Click on this stopwatch button to create a keyframe on offset. Now select the layer, hit U on the keyboard to bring out the active keyframes. Go to the end of this animation. Click on this timing button to add a keyframe and lock this value as it is. Go to the center of this animation, maybe on 5 seconds right over here, and we have to set the X value maybe 3000, just like this. And now we will get something like this, which is looking very interesting, as you can see. And now you can minimize the layer. Now select the shape layer. You can minimize this turbulence displace effect, and we have to apply one more effect. So just go to effect and preset and search for ramp. So this is the gradient ramp effect. Let's apply this gradient ramp on this shape layer, and we have to create nice and simple gradient color. So here we have the start color and the end color. Select the start color and the end color and create nice and simple gradient color combination. And here we have the gradient point. So you can place the gradient point and create nice and simple gradient color, just like this. Alright, and after that we have to apply one more effect. So just go to effect and preset and search for glow effect. So this is the glow effect. Let's apply this glow on this shape layer, and here we have to do some settings. So this is the glow radius. Let's set the glow radius value 500. Let's down the intensity and set it to 0.5. Now it's looking perfect. After that, we have to create duplicate of this shape layer. So select the shape layer, hit Ctrl D to duplicate. let's drag the shape layer right over here and place it like this. And we have to change the color. So it's very simple. Here we have the gradient ramp. Select the gradient ramp effect. You can minimize the glow and the turbulent displace. Select only gradient ramp. And here we have to change the color. Just like this. All right. And now select the shape layer 2 and select the gradient ramp. Here we have the gradient point. You can move the gradient point and create nice and simple gradient color just like this. And now we have to create one more copy. So select the shape layer 2, hit Ctrl D to duplicate and open this shape layer 3, open this contents, open this ellipse 1, open this ellipse path 1, and here we have the size. Let's down the size and set it to 500. Now you can minimize the shape layer 3, select the shape layer 3 and drag it right over here. And after that we have to change the color of this. So select the shape layer 3 and again you can minimize glow and this turbulent displace. Select the gradient ramp and we have to change the color. Just like this. Alright, so here we have the gradient point. You can move the gradient point and create a nice and simple gradient color. And now we have something like this. It's looking nice. And now we have to create glass effect. So it's very simple. Just select this rounded rectangle tool and let's create a rectangle box just like this. Open this rectangle 1, open this rectangle path 1, and here we have the x value and the y value. So unlink the x and y and let's set the size 1450 in width and 750 in height. You can increase the roundness, so I'm going to set the value 100. Now select the shape layer 4, right click on that, click on rename and let's call it glass. And after that let's set the anchor point in the center. So hold Ctrl on the keyboard and just double click on the span behind tool and set the anchor point in the center. Select the glass layer, go to align, and if you don't have this align then go to window and check this option align. After that click on this align horizontally, click on this align vertically. Basically we have to set the shape in the center. Select the move tool and we have to convert this shape layer into adjustment layer. So it's very simple. Click on this toggle switches and here we have to check this option. And now this is the adjustment layer. After that let's apply blur effect on this glass layer. So go to effect and preset and search for blur. So this is the fast box blur effect. Let's apply this fast box blur effect on this glass layer and let's increase the blur radius. So I'm gonna set the blur radius maybe 50 and let's decrease the iteration and set it to 2. Now it's looking perfect. After that we have to create a duplicate of this glass layer. So select this glass layer, hit Ctrl D to duplicate, right click on that, click on rename and I'm gonna call it whiteness. So we have to turn off the adjustment icon and make it normal layer. Select the whiteness and let's delete the fast box blur effect, make it like this. Now hit T on the keyboard to open this opacity and let's set the opacity maybe 10%, and you can see the effect before and after. Alright, so it's looking much more interesting. Now you can close the layer and we have to create one more copy. So select the whiteness, hit Ctrl D to duplicate. And for this one, we have to turn off the fill, set it to none. Turn on the stroke, set it to solid color. Let's set the white color and set the stroke thickness to pixel. Alright, now select the layer, right click on that, click on rename and this is going to be the stroke. Select the stroke layer and hit T on the keyboard to open this opacity. Let's set the opacity 35%. As you can see, we have the border around the edges and it's looking perfect. After that, click on fit. And as you can see, we have the glass effect. And now you can add anything on this glass. So I'm going to add some text over here. So select the text tool, go to character. If you don't have this character, then go to window and check this option character. And here we have to select our favorite font style. So in this case, I am using this Gotham font style. You can select any font style that you like. We have to set the size of this font, maybe 160 pixel. Let's set the line spacing 160. Click over here and type anything that you like. Hit Ctrl A to highlight all. Set the style maybe book and select the bottom line and let's set the style medium. Now select the move tool and place the text right over here. And we have to add some details. So select the text tool again. This time let's decrease the size and set it to 40 pixel. Let's set the line spacing auto and you can set the style book. And now click over here and type description. Just like this. All right. And after that, select this move tool and let's place the description right over here. And now you can blend the text from here. So click on this toggle switch edge and here we have the blending mode. So let's change the blending mode to overlay. Now it's looking much more interesting. And after that, you can add some extra stuff like button or something else. So I'm going to create a button right over here. Just select the rounded rectangle tool, click on the blank area, and let's create a button like a structure just like this. Open this rectangle one, open this rectangle path one. And here we have the size. First of all, we have to unlink the X and Y value. Let's set the X value to 50, Y 60. You can increase the roundness and set it to 100. And now you can close the shape layer, right click on that, click on rename, call it button. Select the button layer and you can set the stroke maybe 2 pixel or 3 pixel. And we will get something like this. Now we have to type a text inside of the button. So select the text tool, click over here and type anything. Now select the move tool and let's set the text in the center of this button. Just like this. Now you can click on fit button. And now it's almost ready, as you can see. So just go to very first frame of this animation, go to full screen and let's have a look. Alright, so it's looking awesome and that's all for this tutorial. I hope you guys like it. If you like it, then hit the subscribe button, turn on the bell notification for more interesting videos. My name is Vikas and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.